Really?
Thank you, Councilor. Anybody else want to make a, yes, Paul, Councilor Stewart.
Thank you, Chair. I share your disbelief and uncomfortableness, the fact that it's a Labour member that is before us this evening. However, I just wanted to reassure the victims that irrelevant as to what region have decided, the Labour group overwhelmingly supported the Chief Whip's recommendation, which was to withdraw the whip indefinitely. Now, I can't apologise enough for the heartbreak that you will have had to have gone through. And it shouldn't be me making that apology, nor this committee. But I am somewhat disappointed to think that region have overturned the decision. The group clearly had no confidence in Louise after the investigations. And for region to then overturn that is disappointing, to say the least. You have our full confidence and full backing as a Labour group.
Anybody else? No, I'm going to draw your attention to page 1 of the report, and there are a number of recommendations there. If you'd like to look through them and consider whether as a group we agree with them, I'm going to put some links to the committee, which I hope will inform the room by the committee. If you're ready for me to do that, if you're ready for me to do that, I'll go now. Okay. I would like to say that holders of public office should act solely in terms of public interest. The Members' Code of Conduct is based on the 7 principles of public life as set out in the Localism Act, the NOLA principles. These include the principles of selflessness, integrity, honesty and leadership. The panel's decision in June showed how Councillor Louise Rees-Jones' conduct had fallen short of these standards and showed how the wrongs committed might be put right. What we've heard today is that, instead, Councillor Louise Jones' conduct continued in the same vein as before, seeking to wrongfully blame and victimise the whistleblowers in this matter, and doing as little as possible, as late as possible, in order to maintain her position. I propose, therefore, that the committee notes the panel's decision of the 15th of June 2017 and acknowledges the actions of the local Labour Party in suspending Councillor Louise Rees-Jones the party with. But Councillor, ask Councillor Rees-Jones to now make, required to make the full and public apology to the complainants and to cease their victimisation. And by way of clarification on this point, I would like to point out that the apology given should be given in writing to each of the complainants within 14 days and should be worded in such a way as to show that Councillor Louise Rees-Jones appreciates that through her actions in breaching the code of conduct, she damaged others, and she undertakes to apologise for that and agrees not to do that again. I then would ask that we consider that Councillor Rees-Jones has failed to abide by the panel's decision. I wish to make it clear that it's expected that Councillor Rees-Jones does write that and make that apology as I've set out. That Councillor Louise Rees-Jones continues to seek victimise the complainants even after the panel decision, and then sought to cover up when a further complaint was submitted and showed herself to be an unreliable witness before the investigators and the panel. That ask the committee to ask that the Labour group consider the further information and what steps they might like to take now as a group and party discipline within their procedures, and that I, as chair of this committee, will write to the leader of the Labour group on the council to express how seriously the committee regarded the original breach and the further actions of Councillor Louise Rees-Jones, and ask that the actions of the Labour group and the Labour Party should reflect the seriousness that we regard with which this situation is regarded by us. Ask also that Councillor Louise Rees-Jones now fulfil the actions required her to make a full public apology as I've set out. Finally, this committee also formally apologises to the whistleblowers in this case on behalf of the council, and in the absence of Councillor Louise Rees-Jones having done so as required by the standards panel. Their decision to come forward and highlight the issues they identified was both brave and borne out of nothing other than the desire to do the right thing. As a result, they have become the targets in a series of accusations and allegations as outlined in the papers before the committee, that as the council instigates reports show were false and indeed vindictive. Their behaviour was and continues to be exemplary and should be applauded. And because of that, I'm asking that the issue of whistleblowers who are outside of the council should be referred to the audit committee or the appropriate committee for examination to see what policy should be developed on that issue. Are we happy to agree with that statement?
I hope you agree with that statement, Chair. Can I just add that as well as the written apologies from council review next year, that she also formally apologises to the council, the next council, in December?
Okay, can I put that to the committee? All those in favour, please show. Professor doesn't have a vote, I'm opposed in favour as well. Okay, that's agreed. And I think that concludes the business of the evening. And I thank everybody for their attendance.
Thank you.